I guess the direct translation of coffee drinkers would be bebedores de café.
Bebedores de café.
Who drink coffee. But a cool and, you know, informal way to say would be we kind of put everything together. So it would be cafezeiros.
We like informal.
Café, which is coffee. So cafezeiros, it's like people who are into coffee, right? So you can say hola, right? There will be something like hola cafezeiros. Or somebody.
This is my Portuguese
Brazil,
lesson.
Brazil, I can say hola cafezeiros do Brasil.
Okay, hola cafezeiros do Brasil. So coffee drinkers, cafezeiros do Brasil, coffee drinkers of Brazil. I'm coming to Brazil. I'm coming to do this thing for my good friend, Jacques Figueras. And it's like a live conversation, live Q&A, and also a concert and all this stuff. More information on that to follow. But then Jacques, he said to me on the phone, he's like, well, look, man, I know you and I know you're not going to come down here for one thing. So for sure, you're going to do a tour. I was like, well, why not? Obviously, you've seen in previous vlogs, my good buddy who was just giving me that Portuguese lesson and how to say hola, cafezeiros do Brasil, that my good friend Gabriel Santiago, we worked a little bit together in Texas about 6 months ago, and we've been planning this project. We keep planning it, and it keeps getting pushed back, but this seems like a perfect time to go play some gigs and then go straight in the studio and actually finally record this project for real and do it in Brazil with a great Brazilian drummer. And so this is where you guys come in. Everyone who is down there in Brazil. I know there are a ton of coffee drinkers in Brazil. I see you guys' comments. I see you guys posting on Instagram. I know Brazil brings the energy when it comes to music, especially when it comes to my music. I'm really, really appreciative of that, and I do not go there enough, but now it is happening. But the question is, where should we go? I'm coming to Sao Paulo for sure. We are also thinking Belo Horizonte and Rio, but then outside of that, where are you guys? Where are all the cafezeiros in Brazil? We would like to know. Please leave comments, leave feedback below this vlog, and let me know where we should come and play. We're in the planning stages right now. I'm 100% confirmed to do this one event with my buddy Jacques, and then he and I and Gabriel and a few people are going to work on putting some dates in around that, because Brazil is obviously a really long way to go just for one night. So let's do this. I've had this Ronaldo jersey since I was like 17 years old. That's a really long time. Was a huge fan of Brazilian football. I was a huge fan of Ronaldo back in the day. I've always been a big fan of Brazil. Always come down there a bunch with other people, but never with my own thing. So it'll be great to come and do this concert. It'll be great to come and do a little tour with Gabriel. So just let us know. Everyone in Brazil, let us know. Below the video, leave us some comments. Let us know where we should go. The more comments you give from your city, the more likely it is that we will put a gig together there. On with today's vlog. A little more Q&A. There were some great questions that came up after yesterday's vlog, and I want to address some of them now. Also, tomorrow's vlog, Chelsea said to me, did you do Q&A without me? Like, she was sad that I did Q&A without her. So leave us some questions for a dedicated Q&A, Janek and Chelsea Q&A, and we will get to that. Maybe tomorrow, maybe the day after, but it'd be really fun. We haven't done one of those in a really long time. It'd be really fun to do one. Leave all your questions for me and Chelsea below this video, and we'll get to it, and we'll do a special Chelsea and Janek Q&A for the vlog. The first question, and it's a really good one, and it's something I get asked quite a lot, is from Charles Coleman, who writes, the Blue Whale Band brings to mind a question I've been wanting to ask. By the way, he's referring to a show I did in February at the Blue Whale with a band I put together at the last minute with Steve Haas, Roslyn Sirota, and Bob Shepard. It was a quartet gig. We played all my music. I will link to that entire concert below in the description of this video. I get the impression that almost all straight-ahead jazz players have about zero interest in playing with electric bass players. That's quite accurate. Has that been your experience? Is it kind of a waste of time to put a whole lot of effort into studying that music on electric bass? Obviously, there are exceptions, such as the people you were playing with in that clip. It's a great question, and having lived in New York for quite some time, I lived in New York for about 10 years and was very much kind of in the jazz scene, whatever that means anymore, but I was in the jazz scene, and absolutely it affected the amount of calls I got as a jazz bass player. The fact that I only played electric and I didn't play upright. And I think this will be also a great one for us to answer again with me and Chelsea together, because she plays both and has a different perspective on it from me, for sure, and probably some great insight. But from my perspective, jazz and jazz that involved an acoustic bass and four and a bar walking bass line type technique was something that was hugely inspiring to me. So it wasn't a waste. Even if I didn't really ever do too many of those kind of gigs, it was never a waste to work on that music and to learn from that music. You know, I listen to a lot of Chopin. I don't ever get called to play it, but I do listen to it and I do study it and check it out and try and play it on my instrument. So I don't think it's ever a waste to study that. It may perhaps not be the greatest avenue to walk down in terms of, you know, trying to work a lot as an electric bass player, playing straight ahead jazz and walking four beats in a bar. And it's also quite an art to come close, you know, to even mimicking or replicating what an acoustic bass player does, what an acoustic bass player's role is in that style of ensemble. It's very tough to replicate that on electric bass. And I would say 98% of the people I listen to on electric bass try and do that, get it wrong, and haven't really figured out the shape. If you imagine the shape of the waveform, if you were recording this in like Pro Tools or Logic or something, the acoustic bass has a lot of attack up front and not a lot of sustain. And the electric bass kind of has, depending on how you play it, can have a lot of attack, but it does have way more sustain. The waveform, the shape of the note is way different. So you have to adjust your technique accordingly in order to fit with that style and with that sound. So that's definitely something I worked on a lot. It did not pay off in terms of the amount of work I was able to gain from that, but then that wasn't my intent in the first place. I was just hugely, and still am, inspired by musicians like Paul Chambers and Leroy Vinegar and Reginald Veal and there are just too many incredible upright bass players to name, and I feel like if I tried to give a list, I would leave way too many of my favorites out. So I guess I'll leave it at that and let you make up your own mind, you know, what is the best choice for you. Next question comes from STXXCRISLE. I don't know what this is. Here's the question. Hi, Janek. I'm curious. In your books and PDFs, you use crazy amounts of ledger lines rather than changing clefs or a simple 8VA marking. Is there a specific reason for this? No offense intended, but 90% of my music professors would not accept a chart that could so easily be made more legible. Okay, so two things with this. Number one, I have noticed some people comment on that in the past. That is why with the brand new books, with the Chop Builder series, everything is pretty much within the five lines of the notation staff. There's nothing really stepping outside of that, no huge ledger lines. But when it comes to ledger lines, I mean, I don't know why your music professors wouldn't accept a chart if the chart was written correctly in the right register on the correct ledger lines. I think it's a little bit lazy, perhaps. Yes, I agree with you that the 8VA thing can be totally useful. But also, when I put out books and PDFs, these are designed as practice tools, and that is an element of a potential practice routine, especially if you're working on sight reading. And I got to tell you that every situation I walk into that involves reading, albeit not that many, I don't get called to do too many reading gigs. I don't think too many reading gigs exist. I got to tell you that most of those situations are not perfectly written charts. They're not all in the right register. They're not all in the right clef. And it is fantastic practice to be in control of knowing where those ledger lines are and improving your sight reading. If you have the option to push yourself and to test yourself and to try and push yourself to the next level, I would suggest taking it. That's always been my philosophy. I always want to push myself a little bit harder. So if that means working on a ton of ledger lines, then I'm going to go for it. David Kemp asks, hey, Janek, when will we be able to hear the new album with Dennis Chambers? That is an amazing question. I wish I could answer that question. I want to know the answer to that. It's really all on me doing the editing and then sending the files off to Tim to do some guitar stuff and then getting to New York to mix that stuff. I'm guessing tentatively like a 3 to 4 month timeline on that. Wish it could be sooner, but things are just insanely busy with traveling coming up over the next couple of months. So as soon as possible, I really want you guys to hear it. It was such a fun thing to be a part of, and I think we got some good stuff out of it. Julian Fernandez left a comment on yesterday's vlog saying, is that Blair Sinter on drums? That is very much Blair Sinter on drums on the clip that I showed from the Jonah Smith gig here in LA. And Julian also says, Lizzie is great, by the way. Yes, Lizzie is fantastic. She's an really, really great singer, an equally great guitar player. Love working with her. I did notice some comments about Janek is back, daily vlog, etc., etc. I don't think it's going to be daily. I'm not pulling a Casey Neistat and going straight back to daily vlogging and committing to 500 episodes or starting a new company or anything crazy like that. But I do want to put up the vlog a little more regularly than I have been over the past 6 months or so, especially now the book project is out of the way and I'm going to be traveling and doing some really fun, really interesting gigs all around the world. Starting, if anyone is in the Denton, Texas area, next week with the Brecker Brothers Band. Really looking forward to that. Check the tour schedule. It's linked below on my website in the description of this video. And there's been some fantastic feedback about all the Bob Reynolds tour dates, and it looks like a bunch of people are coming out to see the show. So we are really happy about that. We really appreciate you guys and your support, and thank you in advance for buying tickets and to come into the shows. I know it's going to be a really fun 2 weeks. We're really gonna get to stretch. You know, we've been playing here once a month in LA. It's very, very different to then go and play every night and to really get into some new things. So we are really psyched to be able to share that with you guys, and I'm really happy that so many people are giving so much positive feedback. If you don't know about this tour, check the tour dates. They're all on my website. We're coming to Europe with Bob Reynolds with the quartet. Okay, that's all I've got time for today. Don't forget to hit the thumbs up, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel if you're not already a bona fide coffee drinker and subscriber and follower. And don't forget to leave questions for myself and for Chelsea, and we will do a Chelsea and Janek Q&A coming up in the next couple of days. Physical copies of the new books just went live on Amazon. They are linked below. I know there are a bunch of people that dig the physical copies of the books. So at least the two bass ones right now, we're still waiting on the two guitar ones to go live, but the two bass ones, Major Modes and Minor Modes, are live. They are linked below. If you're buying the book, the physical book on Amazon, there is no video companion, but you can go to my website and the video only companion, just the video accompaniment for the book, is available there for download. So today's vlog is done. Brazil, let's see what you got. I'm really, really curious to see where you guys are and where you want me and Gabriel and this project to come and play. Okay, today's vlog is done. Enjoy the music on the way out. We'll see you guys very soon. Thank you. Thank you.